G'day, Professor Joseph Drew here. This is a new series of videos. There will be several of them looking at the strategy of special rate variation. So if you're a local government in New South Wales and Victoria and you need to apply for permission in order to increase your rates by more than the rate cap, well, this is a series of videos that you really need to watch. If you're a local government in one of the other states and you want to know how things are done elsewhere and you want to know whether we can, in fact, precisely empirically estimate what your community is capable of paying and what your community needs to pay as a rate, well, this series will also be very helpful. So stay tuned. I'm starting at the very beginning. When do you need to start thinking about special rate variations? And how do you start the process? Now, it's important to note I'm speaking from experience here. I've led two councils through this process successfully, so I'm drawing on my experience as well as my knowledge as an academic. So you need to start thinking about, do you need a special rate variation? The chances are you probably do this year, because what's happened in New South Wales and Victoria, the rate caps have been announced based on historical data, not taking into account that we've shifted into a new high inflation cycle. In real terms, the taxation revenue for most New South Wales and Victorian councils is probably going backwards by 2 or 3% this year. Now, inflation is an emerging story. It's still growing. We're nowhere near peaking. So my question is, will you be able to balance next year's budget or the budget after? What happens if the next lot of rate cuts are also extremely low and insufficient for the circumstances you're facing? You need to think ahead because you only get this one opportunity a year to fix the shortfall if you're short of taxation. And if you don't do it, worst case scenario, you can join the two or three other councils that have simply run out of money and been put into administration. So are your budgets balanced? Is your debt manageable? I'm talking not just about your explicit debt with banks or treasury corporations, but also your implicit debt. Are you keeping up with your asset maintenance? Are you keeping up with important asset backlogs? If you're not doing those things, guys, you're simply going to have to apply for a special rate variation. Are your long-term financial plans plausible? Often they're not when I look at councils' work. Their assumptions are optimistic. Optimistic about growth, optimistic about relatively low increases to the cost of materials and contracts and staff. Now, as I said before, and there's a video on this, where we've shifted into a high inflation environment, a lot of those LTFPs just won't stand the test of that new environment. So if you haven't already done it and watched that video, do so. Revise your long-term financial plan. And I think it's quite likely at the end of it, you might be asking yourself, well, yeah, we need to start this conversation about special rate variations. Does your local government area have intergenerational equity? A lot of local governments are confused about this. They think that merely by taking on debt that gets you intergenerational equity. It doesn't. There's a lot of criteria you must fulfill to actually achieve that, and there's a separate video on that, and I encourage you to watch that one too. But most importantly, can you meet the coming challenges? And there's a lot. There's the high inflation environment. Yes, we understand that. We know interest rates are going up on our debt if it's not fixed. That's happening. We know that the next lot of EBAs for wages will be much higher. The minimum any employee, any union's going to ask for is inflation. And that's well over 3% now and nowhere near peaking. We've got potential more supply shocks, potentially more shocks with things like COVID. Potentially more shocks because of geopolitical instability, reflected in the cost of goods, reflected in the cost of debt, reflected in growth, the growth of your businesses, which will and could mean that you're having to cope with a lot more bad and outstanding debts in the future. Are you going to be able to cope with all those situations? Think about the worst case scenario and ask yourself honestly, will this long-term financial plan, will our budget cope with it? If it won't, if you're not certain, you can't risk your community. You need to start thinking about this special rate variation if you've got questions. So when do you start? The time to start is now. So many councils leave it till October, November. It's really too late. to you don't want to be doing this work over the Christmas break if you can avoid it. A, you're going to find it hard to get the work done. That's when a lot of people plan to take leave. A lot of commercial consulting houses won't be able to meet your fulfill your requirements over that time, or if they do, they'll have to pay their own staff more, which will get transferred into your costs. There's no harm in starting this process now, and in fact, I would start the process now. It avoids your community getting shocked, it avoids your counsellors getting shocked. And how you start this process is you look at your situation and you ask those questions I asked in the last slide. And if you're not sure about any of those answers, then you go to this next step. And the next step is to get a bona fide expert. Not someone that runs around saying, I'm an expert. Someone that can actually prove it. Someone that has a scholarly record. Someone has a record of doing consulting and special rate variations for other communities. But most importantly, someone who is fiercely independent, who will tell you the truth, who is not sweating on this revenue to fulfill the requirements of their shareholders or their partners. Who doesn't mind if the financial sustainability analysis reveals that you don't need an SRV and doesn't mind that they don't have to on-sell you other SRV products and make more money out of you. That's the kind of person you want. Now, I do special rate variations amongst a lot of other consulting I do in Australia for state governments, for federal governments, and abroad. I've done quite a few consulting engagements abroad. I won't do a lot of them. I will only look at one at a time because I believe you deserve 100% of my attention. They are very complex things. So if you're looking to go to me, for instance, and I'm not telling you have to, there's other options, but if you're looking to go to me, the sooner you start talking to me about it, the sooner I can carve out some time, tell you what's involved, start to talk to your counsellors, and yes, unlike a consultant, I will talk to your counsellors. I will talk to your community. I will talk with your key staff and I will answer the questions and I will give you the honest advice. And there will be a video popping up very shortly about this and about the need to get honest advice and about the need to have consultants who have integrity. And you can't assume that you will get that. You need to be very careful about who you engage. So I'm not saying it has to be me, but you have to get someone with these characteristics. If you don't, you're disadvantaging your community. It's going to cost them more. The SRV may not be successful, but more importantly, you won't be getting the truth. You may go for an SRV when you don't need to, simply because someone wants to on-sell you something. Or you may not go for as large an SRV as you need simply because it's a little bit extra work for the commercial consulting firm and they want to maximize their profit and minimize the work. You need to go to someone that you know will tell you the truth. You need to start these conversations with your community and with your counselors and with your other staff. You need to be talking about these challenges. Unfortunately, we have a federal government and a treasury that's still in denial about inflation. But the inflation is there. It's starting to get embedded. We can see that in the producer price indexes I've discussed in previous videos. We've got PPIs in Germany of 24, 25%. PPIs in China of over 12%. Inflation is going to be here for a long time. It takes a long time to peak. Now, the Barrow boom took 2 to 3 years to peak. And then it takes an awful long time to come back down again. That's one of your challenges. COVID hasn't disappeared. The economic stress that your businesses and residents have been placed under, a lot of them haven't actually fully felt that because previously we had this Commonwealth and state government support and that's now been withdrawn. So a lot of more people are going to feel stress and won't be able to pay their rates on time or their fees and charges on time. And then you've got new wage negotiations coming up. They're going to be asking for a lot more money because in real terms they have to keep up with inflation. That's a lot higher percentage than previously. There are just so many challenges, geopolitical risks. There's so many risks. You can't be skating close to the wind at the moment, at this point in time. Maybe a few years ago you could cut it close and try to muddle your way through. But in the environment we're going to see for the next couple of years, you can't be cutting it close. you need to be comfortably financially sustainable. So I hope that video is helpful for you. In subsequent videos, I'm going to go about the task of telling you how to estimate efficiency properly, how to evaluate financial sustainability properly, how to evaluate debt capacity properly, how to evaluate the capacity of your community to pay, and how to present this information to your community and your councillors in a way that doesn't result in political costs, in large costs. SRVs can be done successfully with no casualties. And that is my goal, is to teach you how to do these things. Thank you for joining me on this journey, and I look forward to our subsequent videos together. Thank you very much for your time. Goodbye.